We're in the state capital, the Horseshoe, in Columbus, Ohio, will be the battleground for today's game. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He sends this one deep from his own goal line. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 25-yard line. Ohio State's coaches admitted to us that they game plan around this guy. It's kind of different for a wide receiver. It's usually a running back or a quarterback, but he's paid off for him so far.
He really has, and I found it very refreshing as we travel around the country and visit with so many of these players to find a high-profile wide receiver who's a selfless guy. He's a great leader from everything that they've told us. He's a guy that wants to go out there and make sure that the team gets the win first before he gets his catches. Kind of a rare breed in today's game of college football, but he's an exceptional player.
First guy on the field and the last guy off in practice. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Tackle made at the 33-yard line.
Well, it's a nice first down by this offense, and you can see the wide receiver here carries the football. You're talking about a very versatile offense that's tough to defend and very unpredictable.
And he shoved out of bounds around the 46-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. To the 20. The 10. And he's taken down at the 3-yard line. Perfectly run option keeper.
Not what you'd expect when you prepare all week to defend the option. But then again, give this offense some credit. These guys aren't exactly the scout team.
It's first down. So inside the 5 with a first and goal. Defense and their short yardage package. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
From the 11-yard line, second down. Williams gets a carry right side. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Williams gains around 6 yards on the run. Here's the 8th play of the series. And he's tackled after positive yardage. A gain of about 4 yards on the draw. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The Scarlet Knights saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. He scrambled, runs with it, and he's got room. And he dives forward.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
From their own 37-yard line, first down. Nice run up the middle. Complete. He's got room to work. Tackle at the 49-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
First and 10. Ball on the 49.
Let's go! Green 95! Green 95!
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. They'll bring him down at the 45. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. These fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. He gets rid of this one. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And this one's going out of the end zone for the touchback. The offense goes back out onto the field after picking up a field goal on their last drive. Ohio State is up by three. He's into the open field. And they get nice yardage on that run. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's into the open field. He's knocked out of bounds at the 49. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
From the 49-yard line, first down.
Get him. Mike eight.
He's at the 40. He's tackled at the 36-yard line. And the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 3-0, Buckeyes. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter.
Three down. Mike 8!
Gets to about the 34-yard line. It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on 34. Heading for the corner. Makes it out to about the 26. Ohio State holds a field goal lead. Tackled for a loss. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere. From the 26-yard line, it's second down.
Mike 8.
He He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. This is the eighth play of this drive. Strike to the back, no good.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers.
He's to the 40. Makes it to the 44.
We've got a first and 10.
Ball on the 44. Complete. He's got room. And they make the stop at the 50. He's at the 40. And he hits him hard at the 32. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From the 32-yard line, it's first down. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
You got to give the receiver a chance to make the play. That was just underthrown.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Five wide. Steps up in the pocket. And he might want it all here, and does! And he came down with it. What a catch!
The kicker on the field. He'll try to put his team up by a point.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
A six-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
So the score now, 7-6.
He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's taken down at the 33.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, in the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's at midfield. Knocked out of bounds at the 39. About 2 minutes before halftime. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
Roger. Four down. Hey, watch number five. Watch number five.
Get down.
Mike
down around the 27-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Scrambling around. He gets hit out of bounds at the 17. Makes his way out to about the 9. He's at 100 yards rushing for the day.
The blockers are getting a tremendous downfield push, and that's contributing a lot to the success that he's enjoying.
There was some movement on the line.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
From the 14-yard line, it's second down. Made right around the 12-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Ohio State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Now he tries to buy some time. They bring the quarterback down. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Ohio State can take the lead here with this field goal. Kick is up, and he got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish. The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
Rutgers will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. From their own 40-yard line. First down. He's taken down at the 45-yard line. The Scarlet Knights call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
Ready, green nine, hot.
Going deep. The crowd of this stadium always a factor in the football game. Wants to go long and does. The defender had it and then dropped it. Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. 9-7, Buckeye.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. We always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. He just drills this one. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith in your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Third and 10, ball on the 25-yard line. You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing. Caught, and that's a first down. And down he goes, around the 40-yard line. Scrambling. He keeps it. Tackle right around the 50. From the 50. First down. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Set, check, check. Thunder. Thunder.
Caught. Open field. And he's tackled
right around the 42-yard line.
What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Set, green 19.
And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 32. They get nice yardage on that run. And this is the eighth play of the drive. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. He scrambles. They'll bring him down at the 15. From the 15-yard line, it's first down. They come out in a five-wide set. The five. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Mike 35.
Touchdown, Rutgers.
Blocking backs do a lot of dirty work during the game, so it's good to reward them. Let them barrel it in for a score once in a while.
Well, that was strength against strength, and the offense won that one. Rutgers holds a four-point lead. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion.
Here we go.
And they won't get the two. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's tackled
at about the 33-yard line.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Mike eight.
He's got an opening, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 37-yard line. Makes it out to about the 49. From their own 49-yard line. First down.
Mike eight.
He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Henderson gets 3 yards on the play. Makes it to the 48-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to know. They don't want none of this.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41.
Tight end, right. Three down. Mike, eight.
And he tackles him hard at the 48. Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done. It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defense.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody.
They line up at the 12. Second down. Rutgers is up by 4. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. Jones picks up 7 yards with that catch. It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. Quickly, and he's got his man. He's knocked out of bounds at the 25. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And they push him out right around the 44-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They make the stop around the 44-yard line. We're headed to the fourth quarter, and both of these defenses are still stealing the show. Rutgers in front, 13-9. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Mike eight.
Counter play.
gains his way to the 36-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Stop behind the line.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
Man left, man left. Four down, Mike eight. Mike eight.
Quick out to his receiver. And he's hit immediately. It's first and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Somebody jumped early down there.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Stroud picks up about 7 yards there after keeping the ball on the option. It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Brought down at the 26-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he hits him hard at the 16-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. And he's level at the 15-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Here he goes. Good open field tackle. Well, this is it. They've got all 4 downs to get in the end zone. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Made around the 9-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. This is the 12th play of this drive. Runs right for a nice game. It's third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. Here's the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds around the 3-yard line.
Man left, man left. Here we go, here we go.
Watch two, watch two.
He's got it out to his tight end. He's in, touchdown, and they take the lead. Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. He makes the PAT. Ohio State ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Scarlet Knights have got to be fired up how this game is going. They still got a chance to win.
Well, you're talking about a huge underdog that's battled the entire game. They've got the football here to start this drive late with a chance to take the lead. You can't even imagine what this would do for this football team if they can put 6 points up on the board.
Fires it out, and he's taken down
right around the 32-yard line.
Just under two to go in the game. Once it all, going deep. And it's going the other way. It's the senior corner. Tackle at the 44-yard line. Oh, no, they really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
From their own 44-yard line. It's first down. Nice run there. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
Penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
We've got a first and 10.
Down.
Ball on the 36-yard line. Henderson takes it right side. Runs outside for a nice gain. Henderson gains about 4 yards on the play. The Scarlet Knights taking their first time out of the half. He's at the 20. Makes his way out to about the 15.
Well, the execution of this offense has been on display here in this drive. They know what they needed to do, and that's pick up the first down, work the clock, and finish this game off. And with that first down, they may have done it.
Makes it to the 12-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
It's second and 7. Ball on the 12. Hand off to the right. He's tackled around the 1 yard line. Just over a minute left. Point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. And he's taken down at the 21-yard line.
Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for 6 that time.
Not looking so good for the offense. At this point, all they can do is put the ball in the air and hope.
Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially. Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled
at about the 35. Might have been some early movement up front.
Just a minute lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. And down he goes at the 40-yard line. Coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.